The skies are polluted. The world is addicted to oil. But we're here to offer a solution.
So I present to you the Cybertruck.
Hey, this is Warren Redlick. I want to talk to you today about Cybertruck's weight. Cybertruck is going to weigh less than people are talking about. You're going to be surprised to see how light it's going to be. I'm going to explain it all. You're going to see why it's going to be so light. Cybertruck's weight matters because if we get the weight down, it means there'll be more range. It means it will cost less to manufacture because there's less material going in. So many advantages. It's going to corner better. It's going to brake better. It's going to perform better. This is going to be an astonishing vehicle. It is going to tremendously outperform the Ford F-150. It's going to outperform Porsches. The way it utilizes space is amazing. This is going to be special. In the Twitter poll that I did with over 350 responses, a significant majority thought that Cybertruck would weigh more than 5,000 pounds. Now, this is specifically, I asked for the dual motor. There's going to be single motor Cybertruck, which is the base model that only has rear-wheel drive. There's going to be dual-motor Cybertruck with all-wheel drive, and there's going to be tri-motor Cybertruck with all-wheel drive, which should be the Plaid powertrain that's going in Model S and the Roadster. Over 65% of people responding to the poll thought that the dual-motor Cybertruck would be over 5,000 pounds. Some thought it would be over 6,000 pounds. The dual-motor Cybertruck will be well under 5,000 pounds. In fact, I think it might be closer to 4,500 pounds or 4,600 pounds, and I'm going to explain why in this video. And not only that, but the single motor Cybertruck is going to be extremely lightweight. The single motor Cybertruck is going to be only a little bit heavier than the heaviest Model 3. Cybertruck's exoskeleton construction saves a huge amount of weight. Even though it's stainless steel, which on its own could be heavy, when you look at it in terms of it being a frame, combined with the exterior of the vehicle at the same time, it's going to end up weighing significantly less than people expect. So if you listen closely to what Elon Musk said during the Cybertruck reveal event, you'll hear something really special. So listen for it, and I'm going to ask if you caught it after you hear it.
Less than the most popular pickup truck in the United States, the F-150. So we didn't cheat in either width, height, or length, and we're able to achieve much greater capability in the same dimensions, same weight.
Did you hear it? They're targeting the Ford F-150, and not only is it within the same dimensions as the Ford F-150, it's within the same weight.
Same weight.
That's the goal, and I'm going to show you what the targeted Ford F-150 is, and how that tells you right off the bat, Elon is aiming for a lower weight. When you look at the dimensions that Elon Musk and Tesla announced for the Cybertruck, they were very, very close to a particular model of the Ford F-150 pickup truck. The length is dead on, 231.9 inches. That's the same length as the supercab model with a 6.5-foot bed. Now, Cybertruck also has a 6.5-foot bed. They're both 231.9 inches long. They're both about 80 inches wide. They're both about 75 inches tall. One thing I noticed when I was making this video was when I was looking at the Ford F-150 supercab, it surprised me how much less room there is inside the cabin of the F-150 supercab. The crew cab is bigger, but the crew cab is longer. That's a much larger vehicle than what Cybertruck is shooting for. But the interior, when you look at the interior pictures, the side picture with both doors open of the supercab, that back seat is much smaller than what it looks like Cybertruck has. Much less comfortable, much less interior room. I don't think you can see that in the F-150 supercab that is the competitor that they were shooting for in terms of dimensions. So you're getting that full 6.5-foot bed, you're getting this huge interior, you're getting spectacular performance, you're getting low cost, and on top of all that, it's gonna weigh a lot less than you were thinking. Get ready, here we go. The curb weight for that model with four-wheel drive is under 4,700 pounds. Now keep in mind the dual motor is all-wheel drive. So if Tesla is targeting the same weight for the same vehicle, we are talking about Elon setting a target of under 4,700 pounds for the dual motor Cybertruck. Shortly after the Cybertruck launch, Elon indicated that the actual size of Cybertruck when it's produced will be smaller than the size that they announced when they had the reveal. He said at one point the lathe would be reduced 6 or more inches. In mid-April, Elon said that the current design for Cybertruck, updated from the original design, is 3% smaller. Now, presumably that means 3% smaller in length, maybe a little smaller in width. He mentioned that it would be smaller in height when it's at the bottom of the suspension, when the suspension is set to its lowest setting. And presumably then weight will also be lower, and 3% of 4,700 pounds is a big reduction in weight. Alwyn Art made this image based on Elon's reference to a 3% reduction in size. It gives some idea of what the updated Cybertruck might look like, although it's certainly not perfect and there may be other changes you can't see.
The Cybertruck, the number one mode of transport for a CyberGo.
What I decided to do was try to figure out how much the Cybertruck exoskeleton would weigh. The typical frame construction of a car is less efficient than the exoskeleton approach. So I broke it down section by section of Cybertruck. Here in this image, you can see the lower side panel of Cybertruck, and I estimated 225 inches long by 25 inches high. Cybertruck as a whole is supposed to be 75 inches high, and this is about one third of the height of the Cybertruck. When you look at this, you can see I'm actually including areas like the wheel wells that are not really part of the structure. So if anything, I'm overestimating the weight of the exoskeleton. It adds up to a little bit less than 22,000 cubic centimeters of 301 steel. That is the dimensions by 3 millimeters in thickness. And keep in mind there's two sides, so you have to double it. You get effectively 6 millimeter thick steel. 301 stainless steel weighs about 8 grams per cubic centimeter. It might be a little less than that, might be a little more than that. And Tesla is using their own custom alloy. They call it 30X stainless steel. It should be in the ballpark of the same weight as 301 stainless steel, which again works out to about 8 grams per cubic centimeter. That works out to about 174 kilograms or 383 pounds. Next, you can look at the upper triangle portion of Cybertruck. That's the side, but up above that first slab section we talked about. And now you're talking the section with the windows. And again, I calculated this assuming that the window sections are stainless steel. In fact, it's probably going to be lighter than this because the glass is going to weigh less than the exoskeleton, but I'm assuming that it's steel, and then we'll talk about windows afterwards. That worked out to just under 11,000 cubic centimeters of 301 stainless steel, taking into account the two sides. It works out to 87 kilograms or 192 pounds. Next, I looked at the very front of Cybertruck. There's this slab at the front of the Cybertruck underneath the light bar. You know, I assumed it was a rectangle. It actually is shaped like a rectangle and then it bends back on the sides, but the corners are bent back a little bit or angled back a little bit. But roughly, I assumed it was a rectangle. Cybertruck is supposed to be 79 inches wide. If it's reduced, as Elon suggested, it might be a bit smaller than that, but let's go with the 79 inches. And this section of the front should be about 15 inches high, could be a little less or a little more, but again, we're ballparking this. That works out to just over 2,200 cubic centimeters, which is 18 kilograms or 40 pounds. Next, I looked at the lift gate, which is 79 inches, again, in width. I used 79 inches as a rough approximation, and I ballparked this one as about 25 inches high. Again, could be off a little high or a little low, but let's call it 25 inches, just a little over 2 feet high. That works out to 3,800 cubic centimeters, 31 kilograms or 67 pounds. And then I looked at the hood. Again, 79 inches wide, and I estimated based on, this is an actual image of Cybertruck from on top, from the Tesla website, and I did my best to estimate based on looking at lines using my software to measure it, and I came up with about 28 inches front to back, 79 inches wide. That worked out to just under 4,300 cubic centimeters of steel, 34 kilograms or 75 pounds. Adding all that together, I found the Cybertruck exoskeleton would weigh about 750 pounds or 340 kilograms.
The greatest evolution in vehicular fashion and function.
I looked for other information about different Tesla models, and I found some information on the Tesla Model S frame, the unibody frame for the Tesla Model S. Now, these numbers are from Teslarati in 2013 or 2014, so they're from an earlier version of the Model S. The Tesla Model S aluminum frame weighed about 800 pounds. My guess is it still weighs about the same weight. There may be some slight changes. But that's not a complete comparison because that doesn't include the doors. It doesn't include some other parts that are counted separately in different areas of the Tesla Model S. Just for example, the frunk and hatch on the Tesla Model S are not counted in that 800 pound weight. I did include the frunk in the weight on the Cybertruck, and there is no real hatch, but I included the lift gate in the weight on Cybertruck. When you add that in the doors, the Tesla Model S adds 200 pounds. Cybertruck's exoskeleton is coming in significantly less than the Model S frame. Not only is it less at 750 pounds for the exoskeleton versus 800 pounds for the Tesla Model S frame, but it actually comes in significantly less when you take out maybe another 50 or 100 pounds for the frunk and the hatch on the Tesla Model S. One of the things I wasn't sure about is whether we should consider the bottom of the Cybertruck. I don't believe that they're going to have 3mm stainless steel on the bottom of Cybertruck. I believe it's just going to be the exoskeleton on top of the skate. The skate for Cybertruck should be somewhat similar to the Tesla Model S or the Tesla Model 3 or Model Y. I'm sure there'll be some differences. It's certainly longer than the skate is going to be on any of these other vehicles. Cybertruck is going to be 225 inches long. That's about 30 inches longer than the Tesla Model S. And it's still maybe at least 20 or more inches longer than the Tesla Model X and much longer than the Tesla Model 3. So there's potential for a very large skate, at least lengthwise, underneath Cybertruck. Cybertruck is going to be similar width to the Tesla Model X, but longer. That gives a lot of advantages. Also, I think the wheelbase may be longer. We're projecting a wheelbase of maybe 150 inches. It may be coming a little less than that if the size is being reduced. But in any event, we're looking at something that's a little bit longer than Tesla Model X or Model S, comparable in width. I don't believe we need to add the weight of the skateboard underneath the Cybertruck into the exoskeleton. There should be some structural components of the exoskeleton that connect to or go underneath or with or otherwise attach to the skateboard. But I don't think that's going to be a lot of weight, maybe 50, maybe 100 pounds on top of it, which could get it close to the same as the Tesla Model S and probably less than the Tesla Model X. A couple of other things to note from that Tesla Model S, those Tesla Model S weight numbers. The battery pack of that Tesla Model S was 1,300 pounds. I believe battery packs are significantly less weight now, and we'll talk about that later. Take into account the motor and the drivetrain, and remember there's going to be three versions of Cybertruck. There'll be a single motor, there'll be a dual motor, one front and back, and then there'll be a tri-motor with one motor at the front and two motors at the rear, or vice versa. The dual motor and tri-motors will be all-wheel drive. That generation of the Tesla Model S had 120 pounds of wiring and lighting. We know that Tesla has made big progress in reducing the weight of its wiring, and it's very likely they will go further with that. By the time they get to Cybertruck, there's a strong chance that they will get further than that, and the wiring will weigh even less. So it's reasonably safe to say the wiring weight in the Cybertruck will be significantly less than this weight we're seeing here. It's also likely that Tesla has figured out ways of making the glass both stronger and lighter. We don't know that. It should be comparable weight in glass. It may be a little less weight. And then we have motors. It's very possible that Tesla has come up with a way of reducing the weight of the motors. They've made them more efficient in many ways. We don't know, but there's a strong chance that the weight of the motors and the weight of the differentials may be less because they're using better materials. They figured out ways of doing things more efficiently. They figured out parts that they don't need. The best part is no part.
The best part is no part. The best process is no process. It weighs nothing, costs nothing.
At the Cybertruck reveal, Elon announced that the single motor Cybertruck would have a range of 250 or more miles. The dual motor would have a range of 300 or more miles. And the tri-motor would have a range of 500 or more miles. The best information I could find to compare models that have single motors versus dual motors, that have rear-wheel drive versus all-wheel drive, was to look at the specs for the Tesla Model 3 to get some idea of how they compare and how the weight might be different for single motor versus dual motor, for rear-wheel drive versus all-wheel drive, and for different size battery packs. The Standard Range Plus has a 250-mile range with a 54-kilowatt-hour battery pack, a single motor rear-wheel drive. That has a curb weight of 3,600 pounds or 1,600 kilograms. The mid-range has a bit more range with 264 miles and a 62-kilowatt-hour battery, or 8 extra kilowatt-hours. That gives you some potential idea of the difference. That curb weight is 3,686 pounds. It's about 60 more pounds or about 30 more kilograms. It works out to about 8 pounds per kilowatt-hour. Turning to the long-range models of the Tesla Model 3, the rear-wheel drive model, which has just one motor, has a 75-kilowatt-hour battery pack and a 325-mile range. That weighs 3,800 pounds or 1,700 kilograms. And the long-range all-wheel drive model, which has now a dual motor and all-wheel drive, so it's adding extra hardware, also has the 75-kilowatt-hour battery pack. And it adds, again, that extra motor, it adds the extra hardware for all-wheel drive. That weighs 4,100 pounds or 1,850 kilograms. I put these in a spreadsheet to get a better idea of how the weight changes when you add more battery, when you add a motor, or when you add all-wheel drive. You can see how the weight goes from 3,600 pounds up to 4,100 pounds based on having a smaller battery pack to having a much larger battery pack, to having one motor versus two motors, and to having all-wheel drive versus rear-wheel drive. Putting all that together, I am able to give a reasonable forecast of the weight and range of the Cybertruck models. This is going to be shocking, and maybe this is a little optimistic. The single-motor Cybertruck will weigh only 4,200 pounds. Not much more than the high-end Tesla Model 3. It will weigh significantly less than the Tesla Model S. The current generation of the Tesla Model S has dual motor and all-wheel drive. There's no single motor version of the Tesla Model S anymore. I'm estimating that it will have a 75 kilowatt hour battery pack, and it will, in fact, the single motor will have a 300 mile range, not a 250 mile range. The dual motor should have a 100 kilowatt hour battery pack, figuring that every kilowatt hour adds 7 pounds, and figuring that adding the motor and all-wheel drive to go from the single motor to the dual motor, which has all-wheel drive, will add 225 pounds. That takes the weight of the dual motor up to 4,600 pounds with a 100 kilowatt hour battery pack and 380 miles of estimated range. With the tri-motor, I figured it would have a 150 kilowatt hour battery pack, which brings the weight up to right around 5,000 pounds, including both the additional batteries and the extra motor. This one extra motor added to the tri-motor. Still has all-wheel drive, so it doesn't really change the drivetrain other than the extra motor. There may be some other changes, but not a lot in terms of weight. And that would bring the tri-motor's range up to 550 miles. I know my numbers are optimistic. I don't think they're crazy. I think if you add a couple hundred pounds, I still think it's amazing to have the base model single motor Cybertruck coming in under 4,500 pounds, which I think is likely. I don't think this is unlikely. I think it's highly likely. And the dual motor will come in well under 5,000 pounds. This makes Cybertruck significantly less weight than the Tesla Model X and competitive with the Tesla Model S. I think this is why many people think Cybertruck, the cyber method of construction, may be the future of electric vehicles and vehicles in general. There's so much weight saving by using this exoskeleton structure. There's also tremendous saving in what's called Capex, the amount of capital it takes to build the car, the size of the factory you have to build, the number of machines you need. You don't need a paint shop because it doesn't have paint. You don't need stamping machines because you're not stamping the metal. All of these things together make the cyber model of construction, the Cybertruck and other future cyber vehicle model of construction, very compelling. If you have any thoughts, of course, leave them in the comments. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. Let's keep talking. Thanks very much.